Good morning, class. Today's chapter 17 is agreement of subject and verb. Clear? देखो agreement. आप agreement word से it should be clear to you. There is some agreement between the subject and the verb. And now what is the agreement? So before starting, let's read few sentences. As you already know that there are two parts of a sentence. Clear? First is subject and the other part is predicate. Clear? So the subject can be singular or plural. There are two parts of a sentence, subject and predicate. Now when we talk about subject, subject can be singular or plural. Look at the following sentences. The moon shines at night. The moon. Here the moon is a subject and it is singular. And what about shines? Shines is also shines is a verb and it is also singular. Bees suck nectar from flowers. Bees are subject here and suck is verb here. Both are in plural form. I like to read books. He is eating pizza. The subject, the moon, I and he are singular, while bees is plural. Clear? So, as you know, singular and plural, now this is one exercise in which for singular subject you have to write S and for plural subject you have to write P. So, the mango is hard and green. The mango is subject here and it is singular, that's why we have written S. Sudha went to the market. Sudha is singular here. Sudha is subject and it is singular. That's why we have written S. The dancers. Dancers. S is there. That means plural. The subject is plural. That's why we have written P here. Now come to next page number 71. Look at the following sentences again. The moon shines at night. The subject, the moon, is singular. The verb shines is also singular. Bees suck nectar from flowers. The subject bees is plural. The verb suck is also plural. Clear? So in a sentence, the verb must always agree with the subject in number and person. Read again. In a sentence, listen carefully, the verb must always agree with the subject in number and person. If the subject is singular, the verb must also be singular. If the subject is plural, then the verb must also be plural. This is known as agreement of verb and the subject. So this is the agreement between subject and the verb. Clear? These are the forms that the following verbs take with singular and plural subjects. This is the column of is, am, are, was, were and has, have. So I am tall. I is singular here and with I we use am. I is singular. You are pretty. We assume you always as plural. So for with you we always use are in present tense. He or she is naughty. They both are singular. He is also singular and she is also singular. So that's why we will use is. Next, was, were. Was, were we use in past tense. And with this singular we use was and with plural we use were. Clear? So I was here, you were sleepy, he, she was angry. Next, has and have. With singular subject we use has and with plural subject we use have. I have a blue pen. You have a sister. He or she has a new notebook. Clear? There is one exercise here. Let's understand by doing this exercise. Fill in the blanks with is, am or are. Radha dash taller than her sister. In this sentence, Radha is a singular subject and with Radha we use is. Next, I am. We use am with I in present tense. Rupam is one, that's why we use is. Rupam is my best friend. This chair is broken. I am sad today. You are wearing a pretty dress. The boys are going on a picnic. Your house is very beautiful. Now come to the next page and next exercise. Fill in the blanks with has or have. They dash my book. They means plural. So what we will use? Have. He dash a cold. He means singular. We will use has. He has a cold. Sarah and Sanjana dash. Sarah and Sunaina dash a test tomorrow. Sarah and Sunaina means two girls are there. When two girls are there, means subject is plural. So what we use here? Have. Mr. Khanna dash have flower show. Mr. Khanna is singular. Subject is singular. That's why we use has. My car dash blue seat covers. Covers are many, but we are talking about my car. My car is singular. That's why we use has. You have a good sense of humor. I have a cold and a fever. The goat has two horns on its head. Clear? So this was your exercise. Do it in your book. And thank you. Have a nice day.